In today's video, I am going to explain anatomy of ankle muscles. Particularly, I'm going to focus on muscles that do for inversion and eversion. Inversion and eversion. Inversion is that you bring the sole of foot inward. That's inversion. Eversion is you bring sole of foot to outside. This is eversion. Let me explain what kind of muscles do inversion and eversion. Let me explain muscles of inversion first. Basically, these muscles pass on medial part of lower extremity. It's basically on medial part. Let me list up these muscles. The first one is tibialis anterior. It passes on anterior part of ankle. Simple. Tibialis anterior. Next three muscles are very deep. Okay. First one is tibialis posterior. Tibialis posterior. Next one is flexor hallucis longus. Flexor hallucis longus. Next one is flexor digitorum longus. These three muscles pass on medial part and posterior part of ankle, and they go to sole of foot. Tibialis anterior runs anterior medial part. Three deep muscles pass posterior medial part of ankle joint. When these muscles contract, that bring foot to inversion. Okay, I will explain these muscles later from different view. Next group is eversion. Main eversion muscles are running like this. There are two muscles. First one is fibularis longus. Fibularis longus. If there is longus, there should be brevis. Next one is fibularis brevis. These two muscles originate from fibula and it runs lateral posterior part of ankle. Then they go like this. Next one is very minor muscle for eversion. Next one is extensor digitorum longus. Extensor digitorum longus. It runs on anterior part of ankle. However, this muscle is kind of minor muscle for eversion. Main muscles are fibularis longus and brevis. Basically, they run on lateral part of ankle. Let me show you from different picture. This is right side foot. You are looking right foot from superior view. This is right side. And axis of inversion, eversion runs like this. It's kind of diagonal. Where muscle runs this area, this is lateral from axis. They do eversion. So muscles running on this area do eversion. On the other hand, muscles running on medial to this axis, they do inversion. So, four muscles that are like tibialis anterior and other three deep muscles run this area. Let's say tibialis anterior runs around this area. tibialis posterior, flexor hallucis longus, flexor digitorum longus run like this area. See, they all run on this area. How about fibularis longus, brevis and extensor digitorum longus? Fibularis muscles run around this area. Extensor digitorum longus runs around this area. See, they all run around this area that do eversion. Does it make sense? Important thing is axis of inversion, eversion is diagonal. This area is for inversion. This area is for eversion. So, if you know where axis is and anatomy of muscles, you can distinguish what kind of muscles do inversion or eversion. Now, let me explain why these movements and muscles are important. When eversion muscles get tight, that brings foot to eversion position, right? They bring foot more for eversion. What's gonna happen? Then your ankle cannot go for inversion. Hard to go to inversion. Does it make sense? Plus, what's gonna happen to connective tissue around fibula? What's gonna happen to myofascia around these muscles? They get tight. Maybe fascia around fibula and muscles get tight. What's gonna happen? Of course, there is tightness. If there's tightness around tissue, you cannot move joint freely. It's literally tight. You can't move body. So when eversion muscles get tight, you can't do inversion. And there is adhesion, dysfunction around fibula. Now, mechanics of fibula is important for foot movement, ankle movement. It's important for knee movement because on superior part of fibula, hamstrings attach, particularly biceps femoris. Biceps is important for knee and hip movement. See, free movement of fibula is important for knee and hip as well. This is why eversion muscles are important for lower extremity. Then let's go to medial part. Let's go to inversion muscles. Again, this is medial view. Inversion muscles run on anterior medial part and posterior medial part of ankle. When these muscles get tight, that inhibits movement of eversion, right? Hard to do eversion. Plus, when these muscles get tight, that may create adhesion and dysfunction around tibia, particularly on medial part. Same like fibula. Tibia is important for foot movement, ankle movement, and for knee movement, of course. And if you follow myofascial connection, that is important for hip movement. Thus, tightness around lower leg, around tibia, around fibula can affect knee movement and hip movement. Sometimes ballet dancers come take my treatment. Their fascia around lower leg is so tight. Their tibialis anterior is tight. Their fibularis longus is tight. Then what's gonna happen? Their ankle cannot move. Plus, their feet don't move. Their knee are hard to move. Their hip are hard to move. Mobility around tibia and fibula are so important. What kind of muscles are there around tibia fibula? Inversion muscles and eversion muscles. See, now adequate tension around these muscles are freaking important. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.